powerful set time deliverance prayer with Jesus. Third R of blessing, favor, deliverance, salvation, and mercy. It was about the ninth hour, counting from 6 a.m. when Jewish day begins, that Jesus died on the cross. Matthew chapter 27 verse 46, Mark chapter 15 verse 34, Luke chapter 23 verse 45 to 46. At his death, power was released over the earth. Power of open doors, power of deliverance, power of salvation, power of mercy, power of breakthrough, power of favor, and power of resurrection. Matthew chapter 27 verses 51 to 54. The whole earth was filled with this power and great things happened. Now, I want you to claim those blessings by praying in faith. At this hour, we are going to pray Psalms 126, 127, and 128 in order to claim the powers that the Lord has released upon the face of the earth. Psalm 126, when the Lord delivered Zion from bondage, it seemed like a dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter, on our lips there were songs. The heathens themselves said, what marvels the Lord worked for them! What marvels the Lord worked for us! Indeed, we were glad. Deliver us, O Lord, from our bondage, as streams in dry land. Those who are sowing in tears will sing when they reap. I pray for you. May the Lord deliver you from every bondage. Every bondage of Satan, every bondage of backwardness, every bondage of setbacks, every bondage of spiritual problems, every bondage of worries, every bondage of the enemy, every bondage of failure, every bondage that have taken your life backwards. May the Lord deliver you from them now in the name of Jesus. They go out full of tears, carrying seed for the sowing. They come back full of song, carrying their sheaves. I pray for you. After this hour of prayer, you are going to experience joy overflowing like a river. I pray for you. All your tears shall be wiped away. As the word of God says in Psalm 30 verse 5, though sorrows may last for the night, but joy comes with the dawn. I pray for you. All your tears of the night will be transformed with the joy of the morning. In the name of Jesus, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Psalm 127. If the Lord does not build a house, in vain do his builders labor. If the Lord does not watch over the city, in vain does the watchman keep vigil. In vain is your earlier rising, your going later to rest. You who toil for the bread you eat, when he pours his gifts on his beloved while they slumber. I pray for you, you shall become a beloved of the Lord. You will sleep and the Lord will bless you. While you slumber, the Lord will visit you with his favor. While you rest on your beds, goodness, mercy shall follow you. In the name of Jesus, amen. Truly, sons are a gift from the Lord, a blessing the fruit of the womb. Indeed, the sons of youth are like arrows in the hand of a warrior. Are you seeking the fruit of the womb? Are you praying for the fruit of the womb, for yourself or for someone? I want you to visualize someone who is seeking God to bless him or her with the gift of a child. May the Lord bless that person right now in the name of Jesus. If you are the one, I pray for you. May the Lord begin to open your womb. May the Lord begin to open for you the favor that comes with the gift of a child, that in your family you will experience the cry of a newborn, and that joy is going to transform into greater gladness for you and for those around you. I pray for you. May the Lord anoint your womb open it once more and bless you as he blessed the women of old, as he blessed Sarah, as he blessed Anna, as he blessed Elizabeth. May the Lord bless you with the gift of a child in the name of Jesus. Oh, the happiness of the man who has filled his quiver with these arrows. He will have no cause for shame when he disputes with his foes in the gateways. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Psalm 128. Oh, blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. By the labor of your hands you shall eat. You will be happy and prosper. I pray for you. May the blessing of God visit the work of your hands, that the work of your hands will yield you profit. The work of your hands will yield you favor. The work of your hand will be multiplied unto your own good. In the name of Jesus, may the Lord bless your business, bless your working place, and grant you job security, grant you business upliftment, grant you favor in life. Bring your plans and aspiration to fulfillment in the name of Jesus. You will be happy and prosper. Your wife like a fruitful vine in the heart of your house. Your children like shoots of the olive around your table. Indeed, thus shall be blessed the man who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion all the days of your life. May you see your children's children in a happy Jerusalem. May you see your children's children in a happy family. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. On Israel, peace. And I pray for you. In your life, you will experience peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, we recall how you sent your angel to the centurion Cornelius at the ninth hour in Acts chapter 10 to show him the way of salvation. Open the hearts of your children who have followed this prayer religiously and meditatively, that they may experience your divine transformation and work for the salvation of the world, so that your church may be firmly established and may bring them and all men into your presence, that they may experience also in their lives divine favors and divine graces through Christ our Lord. Amen. God bless you.